One of the most prolific and gifted Italian singer-songwriters of the 1970s was Lucio Dalla. And in 1977 he released his seventh album,
Come è profondo il mare.
And from that album, the powerful track,
E non andar più via.
Pantaloni in un cortile, ho perso anche una mano in un vicolo, era un pomeriggio di aprile, gli occhi me li ha portati via una donna grassa a forza di guardarla, le labbra le ho lasciate tutte e due su un'altra bocca o su una fontana che essere prudenti non si tocca.
Let's catch up with the lyrics here. The title translates to "and don't go away." In the first few lines translate as, I left my pants in a courtyard. I also lost a hand in an alley. It was an April afternoon. A fat woman forced me to look at her eyes. I left both lips on another mouth or on a fountain, which one does not touch to be cautious. But it burns me like an old fulminant, or you die or I die. From today, Rome will have another god. I'm leaving, I'm leaving.
Brucia come un vecchio fulminante. O muori tu o muoio io. Da oggi Roma avrà un altro dio. Io me ne vado via. Io me ne vado via.
I love the way his voice swells over the like understated piano.
Dove chiudendo gli occhi senti cani abbaiare, dove se apri le orecchie non le chiudi dalla rabbia e lo spavento, ma ragioni giusto seguendo il volo degli uccelli e il loro ritmo lento, dove puoi trovare un dio nelle mani di un uomo che lavora e puoi rinunciare a una gioia per una sottile tenerezza, dove puoi nascere e morire con l'odore della neve, dove paga il giusto chi mangia e chi beve fa l'amore. Dove per Dio la giornata è ancora fatta di 24 ore, puoi uccidere il tuo passato col Dio che ti ha creato, guardando con durezza il loro viso, con la forza di un pugno chiuso e di un sorriso, e corri insieme agli altri ad incontrare il tuo futuro, che oggi è proprio tuo, e non andar più via, e non andar più via. There's so much to take in right here. Hear how the cascading strings in the background are giving this rising, swelling quality. Is that just really compelling guitar, the lyrical sustains over that bomb, 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 bomb type like shift that underlies it all. And I also have to say, I just couldn't interrupt him as he was singing, because his voice is just a beautiful instrument in and of itself. I mean, even if you don't understand what he was singing about, and I don't know the language, just think of the voice in that foreign language as an instrument, as a sound, and the syllables, just the beauty of those syllables, and the way that he was fitting so many syllables per bar, that in that Italian way. It's a language, it's a very kind of like a very multi-syllabic type language. I'll just finish the song and then I'll finish the lyrics.
Oh, Lucio Dalla. Let's have a hand again, the track.
E non andar più via.
Yeah, and don't go away. Let's, the lyrics were kind of interesting, although I can't quite put my finger on, and I don't know, I can't completely vouch for the accuracy of this translation. Let's see. Picking up where I left off. I'm leaving. Where closing your eyes, you hear the dogs barking. Where if you open your ears, you don't close them with anger and fright. Now already, maybe this song has to do with the strife that was going on in Italy at the time, with all the protests, all the street violence. This being the year that famous photo was taken of that shady figure like in the street, like holding a gun. It made all these papers. I think in the act of like shooting someone. There was a statement in, I think it may have been England's Dreaming, John Savage's book, that said, like, in Italy, 1968 never ended. Where did I read that quote? Yeah, in Italy, 1960, intergenerational turmoil of 1968 kind of just lasted through much of the 70s. Let's see, where was I? But just reasons following the flight of the birds and their slow pace, where you can find a god in the hands of a working man, and you can give up a joy of subtle tenderness, where you can be born and die with the smell of snow. Where the just pay the one who eats, drinks, and makes love, where, for God, the day is still 24 hours long. And you can kill your past with the God who created you, looking hard at their face, in the force of a clenched fist and a smile, and run with others to meet your future, that today is really yours, and don't go away anymore. And don't go away anymore, and don't go. I can only surmise that it's just about the strife and that was going on in the country at the time, and misgivings about the situation. The references to the kind of religious references might be getting at the change that Italian society was undergoing. As Camille Paglia has observed, Italy in the last few decades, I guess, has transformed into a more secular society. She thinks that's been to the detriment of the quality of art from that nation, which she refers to as like a post-Fellini slump. I wonder what she would think of some of the stuff from the 70s if she was to hear it, some of the music from Italy during the 70s. I'd be interested to hear her take as like a cultural critic and someone who keeps an eye on Italian culture every now and then. Lucio Dalla, very gifted singer-songwriter, put out a string of really brilliant albums during the 1970s and into the early 80s. And I was delighted, actually. It was sad news, but I was very happy to see it make the front page of Yahoo. Back when I still used to go to yahoo.com for new, back like, oh, 8 years ago, 7 years ago. Yeah, his name trended this one evening on the English, I guess on the main Yahoo. It was nice to see him get that recognition anyway, even if the news was sad. His passing in 2012. The 1977 album.
Come profondo il mare.
Yeah, the track How Deep the or which translates to How Deep the Sea Is. And For more rubies and sapphires from the catalog of Lucio Dalla, see the directory of albums by Italian artists, linked in the description below. For rubies and sapphires from several albums by Lucio Dalla, as well as many other Italian singer-songwriters, symphonic rock bands, jazz rock bands, library musicians, and many more. And like and subscribe and follow me on social media and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the song, any insights you have into these lyrics, anything you might know about the background or the backstory of the, or if you could understand, if you know Italian and were able to understand what he was singing about as you heard it, be even more interested in hear your insights into the track and its lyrics. Until next time, this is Zaragon, the world's most ear-traveled trimaximalist, signing off.